Chicago Ballet. I'm so excited.
Of course, darling. After 10 years together, I figured it was about time.
I always wanted to be a ballerina.
Really? I never knew that.
Oh, yeah. When I was a little girl, I had this music box with a porcelain ballerina inside. I used to sit and watch her spin around on her toes for hours. I was completely obsessed. But I was the only girl I was seven, which has never happened. Ballet lessons were too expensive anyways.
Huh. I always took you more of a sporty type. I guess that was just your brother's influence.
Or my dad, really. He loved baseball. Almost as much as you do. So he started teaching me along with Luke and Tom, just as soon as I learned how to walk. And then, after everything that happened, it was something I could do to feel close to him.
Well, I love how after all this time together, there's still more to learn about each other.
Me too. I love you, John Carmine.
And I love you. Oh, come right here. There you are.
Thank you.
something I could see in architecture, with the Chrysler Building.
You and that Chrysler Building.
Well, it's the same mysterious and graceful beauty. I'd love to get a picture like that.
I'm sure you would. I, for one, can't wait to see the first John Carmine Tower. Hey, do you want to stop and get some dessert? We have a little time.
Dessert and more time without the kids? Sign me up.
Right now, John. I can't. Let's just go home, please.
Fine. We'll go home, but I tell you this, no amount of praying is going to change my mind.
Thank you.
God, my condolences. I don't mean to cry, but is everything okay with you and John?
No, this is war nonsense. Ever since the minute the president announced the attack on Pearl Harbor, John was ready to go. More than ready. Without a second thought to his family or his own mortality.
It is natural for a man to want to protect his family. Bill was the same way. He looked for the next morning and he saw it yesterday.
And you're not mad at him?
Why would I be mad? I mean, sure, I'm worried. But I try to remind myself to have faith. God's seen us through hard times before, and he'll see us through this too. I'll pray for him every day and write to him as often as I can. I couldn't keep him at home, not when there's so much at stake.
I wish that I could see it that way. I really do, for John's sake. I just don't.
You haven't tried talking to him about it?
Oh, I tried. He refuses to listen. I have tried explaining how scared I am that he'll die, how many casualties there already are, how he has children to consider. He couldn't care less.
Why is it that you're so sure he'll die?
He said the exact same thing. War kills people. That is the entire objective of war. I'm not the crazy one.
Sorry, I didn't mean to strike a chord. War is terrible, and there are casualties, but not every man who goes into battle will die. Are you sure this is about John?
I was 6 when the Great War started. And when my dad enlisted, he was so proud. And he said he was so excited to be fighting for his country. And my mom was proud too. But I was terrified. And everyone just kept saying, this is the right thing to do, Evie. Everything's going to be fine. But when my mom got word that he wasn't coming home, she was devastated. We all were. And I did as much of the raising of her kids from that day on as she did. And every day I hated that my father abandoned us. That is exactly what John is doing now. He is abandoning his family for a moment of glory, and I won't allow it.
So you got your papers in?
Oh, I did, yes. Going to Fort Vanderwood on Tuesday. You see, I've got my hair.
You said Fort Vanderwood?
I did.
Man, I wish I was going with you.
Well, you know, active duty isn't for every man, I suppose.
Not for every woman in my case.
What do you mean by that?
Zephyr. She seems to think the minute I step foot over there, I'm going to die. She keeps telling me to wait for the draft. I don't need to wait for a draft. I'm ready to go now.
But I can't blame her for being worried. You know, a lot of men are dying over there. They're, you know, giving the ultimate sacrifice.
I'm willing to make the ultimate sacrifice for her. Does she seem to care about that? No. I'm supposed to be her protector. It's my job. She doesn't seem to think I can do that.
Well, you sure? It's all about her believing you, and it's not something else.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, have you asked her why she's worried?
Seems to think I'm gonna die.
Well, John, you know, be a little complicated sometimes. I think you gotta dig a little bit deeper than that. Well, my wife is trying to get me to go. We're having a big family luncheon and all of that. So I'm sorry about your predicament with your wife, you know, but I'll be keeping you in our prayers.
Thanks, Daddy. Appreciate it. Take care of yourself out there. And go and win the war without me.
Well, it takes at least 2 good Americans to win a war.
That's right.
That much.
Right. Thanks again, Eddie. In fact, I'm going to take care of things first thing tomorrow.
What's first thing tomorrow?
Oh, you remember that latch for the gate? I'm going to go get the part.
Oh, good. Lou, Jackie, it's time to go.
Where did Charlotte go?
I'm trying to watch him get your girl's job.
It's not.
Hey, break it up. Lou, we put you in charge of picking up the kids from the children's church.
I did pick her up.
She's over there with Mrs. Anderson. I'll get her. This is clearly being
called. Thank you, Jackie.
Great, we're all here. Finally. All right, let's head out. And Lou, we have a very serious conversation about watching the kids and the girls' job when we get home.
Thank you. many erected every night, but they fail utterly in every attempt to stem reinforcements. Russia and Russians are determined to hold at all costs. Perish but do not retreat is the order of every day.
I can't keep sitting here pretending like everything is okay while the whole world is at war out there.
I know you want to go, but I need you here with me.
I don't want to go, Evelyn. I have to go.
Why? For your pride?
So what if it is? Maybe I want to go and kill some Nazis. Why don't you? There's a horrible evil out there, and they're attacking our way of life. You don't even seem to care.
Of course I care. There's a darkness in this war that I can barely comprehend. So of course I don't want you running towards it. You're gonna go thinking you're invincible, and I'm gonna be the one left picking up the pieces when you find out you're not.
Just because I'm going doesn't mean I'm going to die.
All I see every time I look at the papers is bad news. Good men fighting evil men and dying. What's to say that won't happen to you?
Faith.
Faith is great, but you have a tendency towards being blinded by stupidity and calling it faith.
I thought you would have changed your mind by now. I enlisted this morning. It's the Second World War. There's no sitting out no matter where I am. I would have been drafted soon enough.
How could
you? Evelyn, wait!
Say something, I'm giving up on you. I'll be the one if you want me to. Anywhere I would have followed you.
him dying. It just kept playing over and over again. I couldn't stop it. I don't know what to do. I want to trust God. And I want to support my husband. But I can't get rid of this fear. And most of the time, it's so overwhelming that I just take it out on John in the form of anger. I want to do, but I can't stop it.
Yeah. Trusting God doesn't always look like a beautiful sunset or a perfectly put together life. It's like this garden. And sometimes it flourishes. And sometimes a storm can come and tear it apart. So you replant. And that's okay as long as you do it.
Have you ever had to replant?
When I found out I couldn't have any children,
I'm so sorry.
No, it's okay. Everyone has that moment where you feel like your burdens are too much to bear. And you ask yourself if God really cares. But isn't that what we see in Jonah?
I just can't see how God could protect Jonah this far. I can't leave it in his hands. I feel like I'm losing my faith.
Remember that garden? When you have a relationship with Jesus Christ, you get your own garden of faith. And so maybe it's winter, but spring will come. I know you have that faith inside of you. And if all it takes is a mustard seed to move mountains, all you need is a grain of sand. As we're trusting in God to protect John, I want to show you something. Here it is. And do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul, but rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a copper coin? And not one of them falls to the ground apart from your Father's will. But the very hairs on your head are all numbered. Do not fear, therefore. You are of more value than many sparrows. I'd love to.
I heard your eyes are on the faithful. You delight in all your saints, but for what of those of us who wander in the darkness and mistakes? Oh, I need to know you see me. With my face down on this floor, have I escaped the scope of mercy? God, is there still more?
I'm still not exactly okay with this. I'm even less okay with our last words to each other being part of one.
Me too.
Trying to trust all the way we apparently do, but it's not easy for me.
It's okay. The war's gonna be over before you know it, and I will be more.
I hope so.
Remember that song from church on Sunday? What am I to dread? What am I to fear? Lean on the everlasting arms.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arms. Walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, leaning on the everlasting arms. Arms. I have blessed peace with my Lord so near, leaning on the everlasting arms. I'm leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarms.
Thank you. All right, off the bus and out in line. Pick up the pace, ladies.
CP, the old P, the MP makes your new cat be. It's a G ride, man. It starts with a beautiful boy wrapped over your bed when you arrive. Hey, Jack, that's a G ride. Groovy too, jump in your suit, make a salute. Hurry, boot, after you wash your dress. Your breakfast from a beautiful looking cafe they call a mess. Hey, Jack, when you got the lesson, out of your seat, into the street.
soldiers pinned down by Nazis across the river. And now we're going to march in and rescue them. Let's move up.
I have run through field and mine.
audition yesterday. I hate to say it, but maybe you were right. Maybe I was a little cocky. Don't get me wrong. I still think I did the right thing. But there were some close calls yesterday. No casualties. But that's the best I can say for the day. It was hard on all of us. Anyways, there's this beautiful field not too far from the camp. It's on the top of a hill with trees on either side. But straight ahead, you can watch the sunrise. I wish I could see all the way back there to the States. See you and the kids. I couldn't sleep last night. I almost did something. It's not... No. What matters is, I chose to stay. Not literally, obviously, because I'm here, but my heart is with you. I love you, no matter what.
My dearest John, I'm sorry I haven't written. After you left, I went into this self-protection mode. I thought if I didn't write to you, didn't think about you, that I could make it hurt less if you didn't make it home. But I realize now that's never going to work. I love you, no matter what happens. I gave you my heart nearly 10 years ago, and I decided last night that my heart will stay with you. Whether I'm angry at you or sad because of you, or celebrating with you, as I hopefully will be soon, my heart will always stay with you. P.S. I'm headed to a victory show in support of the troops. I'll let you know how it is.
Will recall, into line of all things that happened on the holiday.
wizardry show?
Oh yes, it was cute.
It was, but something's been bothering me about it.
What's that?
Captain America? I know it's fun, and it's a great show, but Captain America isn't the savior we need to win this war.
I agree. You know, Captain America is kind of a fun kids' show and storybook, but if anything, it makes me more aware of the fact that we need God to come to our aid, not Captain America.
I know. Everyone keeps talking about the Allied forces, and it makes me wonder, is remembering the most important? Yes. Our hope should be in God, not this comic book superhero. I mean, there's nothing wrong with a little entertainment. But how many people went to that show and left feeling optimistic because of Captain America instead of God?
Perhaps today we should spend our time praying for our country rather than ourselves.
Yes, let's do just that. Thank you.
surrounded, and Evans came running in like a madman. He got me out of there, but he didn't make it. They took him alive.
Where?
There, about a quarter mile east of here.
How many men?
10 to 15.
This just happened.
Yes, I ran back as fast as I could. We gotta go after them.
No, by the time we catch up to them, they'll be too deep into their own territory. We'd never make it to them.
So, what are we supposed to do? We're not just gonna sit here, are we? We gotta go after them!
You remember your place, soldier! We'll get Evans back, but not today. They're probably taking him here. 30 miles behind enemy lines. Our 130 men aren't making it far past that line and back alive, let alone the group of rescue captives.
So what am I going to do now?
I count my blessings. Evans just saved your life. Did he make any special requests?
He mentioned something about writing his mom.
Let's get to it. I have some letters to write too.
God, I came here to defend my country, and in just two battles, I've choked every time. Some American man I am. He was just a kid. What am I going to say to his mom?
You'll see last year's champion, the Rusting Bells, play the Rockford Peaches, and it's shaping up to be the perfect afternoon for a ball game. Wrestling starts in the field with John Winter on the mound. The Peaches are back, leading off with Terry Davis, who today has the best batting average in the league. Before we get started, we've got a group of buddies from all the West America and tribute to our troops overseas.
God bless America. From the mountains to the prairies.
has been gently reminding me that I'm not in control. Which is obvious when you just say it out loud, but it wasn't so obvious to my heart.
That's good. It is funny how it's different knowing something as a fact versus something as a belief.
I must say, I prefer facts. Alright kids, go out back and play with Miss Abby and all the other kids.
How late is this room?
Yeah, the bird rang so late, I didn't even have time to change.
You look great.
Thanks.
So, does anyone have any prayer requests?
I have one, but it's not really about the war.
Well, you're not just here for the war, we're here for each other.
Well, as you know, I've gotten a job. I figured with no kids at home and Charlie off the war, why not contribute how I can? And it turns out that I really love working.
That's great.
It is, but it seemed this whole Rosie the Riveter campaign was all about convenience and not actually about wanting women to work.
Well, what do you mean by that?
Well, I want to keep working when Charlie gets home, and I want to go to college and maybe even become an engineer someday. But I talked to my boss about how to get started, and he just laughed at me. He said that the women won't be needed when the men get back. And so I wrote to Charlie about it, and he said that he didn't understand me either. And it's not just the men. A coworker, Michelle, she overheard me talking with our boss, and she said that it would be disgraceful to keep working when I have a husband at home to take care of. But what's so disgraceful about feeling like I have a purpose? And what's wrong with wanting to work and do well and get promotions?
Even if you already thought you were going to.
Yeah, but it just
just seems the price we're willing to pay now is much higher than it did back in Basic.
Alright.
And to know someone else paid it for you, that's even harder.
Well, Sean already did pay it. A long time ago. Way before this blasted war.
You're not about to preach to me, are you?
You a Christian man, John?
I am.
Well, you already know. I like to think that just the opportunity to maybe make the ultimate sacrifice for my family, for my country, gives me just the slightest glimpse of what it was like for Jesus and the love he had for all of us on Golgotha.
But we have yet to make an ultimate sacrifice, but Evans did for me, and that's why we gotta go and get him back.
Or, instead of feeling sorry for yourself, you could look at it that isn't it just as much of a worthy sacrifice for Evans as it would be for you?
So you were about to preach to me.
Can't help it. Been listening to my father do it for years.
But
I'm done now.
Thanks, Walter. Dear Mrs. Evans, I was up on the hill past the camp, and I was ambushed.
not sure where she is. We were ambushed. The enemy took Terry?
Oh, Linda, I'm so sorry.
He's gonna be okay. Your son saved my life. Evelyn, have you gotten a letter from John?
No, not recently. Why?
It was John. John wrote that letter.
My John? He didn't say anything to me. He could have died.
Years full of suffering and death. and sacrifice. Now the war against Germany is won. A grateful nation gives thanks for victory. Hundreds of thousands crowd into American churches to give thanks to God. President Truman announced the official surrender.
This is a solemn but glorious hour. I wish that Franklin D. Roosevelt had lived to see this day. General Eisenhower informs me that the forces of Germany have surrendered to the United Nations. The flags of freedom fly all over Europe.
Sure is.